about today, think about Black Lives Matter, but also the Syrian refugee crisis. I mean, it's been 50 years that you've wrote Telephone Conversations. It's been 15 years you talked about race. Has anything changed in your opinion?
You know, in addition, in one of the early anthologies, it's not really cited, I actually wrote a poem, actually had a poem published about the same time as the Telephone Conversation. There were two. One was The Immigrant, and the other, The Other Immigrant, a long poem. It's not very often exhumed. And I was very conscious of racism, of course, both subjectively and as an objective fact. I mean, we were living at the time as a student. This was the height of apartheid. And we knew that the basis of apartheid was racism, nothing else, otherness taken to the extreme. And the issue of feeling, the experience of feeling different for the first time in one's life, when I went to when I went to England as a student, was something quite monumental. On the inside, I find it very difficult to believe, because again, sorry, seriously this time, not just Yoruba, but many people, many nationalities in West Africa and in most of Africa are very accommodating. I grew up with white colonials, the colonial masters, with Lebanese traders, Greek traders, we Italians owned construction companies, at least were their building. So I never felt that they were, I didn't feel their otherness strongly enough. I recognized what they were, and occasionally we had clashes, incidents of race discrimination, you know, and they were put to rest very quickly. So now, being thrust for the first time in a white society, and to have to accept the fact that others saw me and reacted to me with a kind of tolerance, condescension, bombarded with stupid questions, you know, ignorant questions, and then actually encountering, I have to tell you this, for instance, and I say this only because I would read something like African smell, you know, etc., dirty and so on. And I find it, at least the British, they stank, you know, they really stank. And I found that there was a distinctive smell, difference of smell between what I was used to with human beings and the British.
Yeah, you describe how both you think that the other one stinks.
How do I describe it? Well, yes. I just knew it was a bad smell. And it took some getting used to.
How did you react? You were young, you were brash. Mm-hmm. Nigerians are sometimes have the reputation of being...
Well, I can imagine that racism made lots of Africans aggressive. Very aggressive. Not just...
Not you.
Not... Me?
Not you back then.
I think, I don't know if my teaming up with some rather militant West Indians could be called aggressive. Thank you.
Unfortunately, this could be a bit rushed. Okay. So I can't offer you, there's no time to offer you my wine.
No problem.
But I want to take this with the painting.
Yes, sir.
So let me bring
Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate it, sir.
Four of these left of the first original edition.
Shegun Lawal. Thank you very much, sir. I really do appreciate it.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.